Dear dreamers, it has been a while, and with all my heart I say welcome back to Emmy O'Sullail Dreamwork. It has been a hot and dry summer here in Sweden with many forest fires, like in many places around the world, and much effort and energy has been needed to help the poor animals fleeing the burning forests and to help people who have been forced to leave their houses. It has also been a full moon and a lunar eclipse. The full moon has been a blood moon too, and it has been in the fierce sign of Leo, forcing what has been in the dark up to the forest to be dealt with, forced in severity and in pain. It has been a trial by fire for many of us. And on occasions like this, it's like the very elements are working along with the heavenly forces, all to show us what is really important in life. What are we ready to let go of? What are we ready to free ourselves from? The full moon is a quite good occasion to let go of those patterns and outgrown things we don't need anymore, and sometimes we also have to let go of dear ones and to allow the grief and the pain coming along with it. I have been dreaming about death, the ruthless harvester, and about mourning and about falling apart. And in the work coming up, I found two old dreams that I want to share with you. In one of them, I found a coffin, a white coffin made out of cardboard, and on it was written formulas and symbols and signs, and on its head's end was a theater mask showing a sad face, but still kind of indifferent. And behind me was a woman that had walked with me to this coffin that was inside a white tent, and we had been walking through conflicting groups and sad catastrophes and things happening. And when standing there, I realized that the woman standing with me was dead, and that she was the one laying in the coffin, and that she was I. And this made me start to cry, but then I heard this voice coming inside of the coffin saying to me that I should not cry. I should applaud, on the contrary, because she had actually transformed into tomatoes. Well, I tried to clap my hands together, and at first it was with quite a hesitation, and I was crying more than applauding, but in time the joy of transformation filled me up. Like a pomegranate, the tomato has seeds inside, and just like the young girl, Corey had to go down to the realm of death in the Persephone myth in order to eat the transforming seeds to be able to come back to life again. We have to say yes to transformation. We have to let go of the old self. The overlapping of dimensions have gone far, and what we think is manifesting faster than ever. I know I have been saying this before, but our fears are tricking us easily if we don't identify them as what they really are. They are fears. And in this time, illusions actually die also if we just are allowing them. And they do so because they have to. Because we have to get rid of our most stubborn patterns. We have to kill our darlings too. If so said, the things that come hardest. Because things are then appearing in their true form, and this is what we really need. Without wrapping paper, without cosmetics, and without masks, the true face is showing. Perhaps not as charming as we want to, but true and naked. The reason why we wear masks in the first place is that we are afraid of being judged and excluded by friends and lovers and family, society, God, and so on. And the survival patterns are created out of fear. But behind the mask is the truth awaiting. And I want to read for you the other dream that I call Taking My Face Back. I am sitting in the back seat of a bus, driving down, writing down my dreams. My family is with me, and also the Swedish singer Patrick Isaacson. He's sitting to the right of me, and he's writing a new song, and we are going north. I find myself outside the bus now, and I look to the east, and there I see I have got a message, like a pin on a string, saying, "The father comes as a thief in the night. It's as taken from the book of Revelation. It's about doomsday and fear. And I feel very angry, upset, and tired of being exposed to these energies. I want to be free of them. I don't want to be afraid anymore. I walk towards west, and there I see a large polar bear standing on its hind legs. It looks at me and expresses huge rage, and it's clearly wanted to attack me. I look at it, and it has long black claws, and I feel my fear growing. And then the polar bear also speaks to me with a high, dark voice, saying, repeating that the father comes as a thief in the night. This is referring to my very old fear of God, actually. It's quite old. And at the time I had a dream, I had freed myself a lot from these things. But I had to take the final step. The polar bear keeps on talking, and he says that he will rip me into shreds if I come closer. But I keep on walking straight at him, and I am yelling back to him, "You will not hurt me, because I am naked and I am unprotected, and I am your daughter." So the polar bear is standing in the west, which is the quarter of death and transformation. The bus is going north, which is the quarter of wisdom. The singer sitting next to me, to the right, is symbolizing intuitive action. It's on his way, and the fact that he is also writing a new song means that a new kind of expression is coming. And this is showed by the symbolism that I'm daring to defy my fear and yelling back at the polar bear, who is superior to me at the scene. He can take me whenever he wants, because he's stronger, he has the power. But not for long, because in the dream I claim my right to meet him. I claim my right to fear my to face my death, to dare transformation. The daughter comes from the father in cyclic terms. When looking at the epochs, and we are facing such a change now when the feminine is taking place on the scene, whatever the masculine is saying or doing to scare the feminine energies off. In my case, this meant, as I said, I was beginning to get ready to challenge my fear in a final way, like in Do or Die, like in Do and Die, because there was and there is no other way than moving out of the minimizing patterns that keep us all behind bars, because if not, they will for sure devour us. They will rip us into shreds. The next full moon is coming up in 2 weeks, so use this opportunity to think over what you will let go of, what you have outgrown, and what patterns you don't need anymore, which illusions you have actually seen through. Let go and make room for new energy. So, dear ones, what are those patterns? What do you need in order to be ready to let them go? use your dreams, they will for sure guide you and show you the way. I love you all, bless you, and see you soon.